Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Crassigyrinus was a carnivorous stem tetrapod from the Early Carboniferous of Scotland and possibly Greer, West Virginia. It was an interesting specimen of an early amphibian due to the fact that it seems to have completely abandoned terrestrial life in favor of an aquatic lifestyle. It grew up to 6.5 feet or 2 meters in length and had tiny limbs and unusually large jaws. Crassigyrinus had a body similar to that of a fish, tapering into an extensive tail with limbs resembling small fins. These fish and tetrapod-like features have confused paleontologists for a long time, and there's still some controversy as to which group it belongs to. Its head was around 1 feet or 30 centimeters long, and its teeth-packed jaws possibly had a wide gape, capable of opening its mouth as wide as 60 degrees, which indicates that it was a powerful predator with a strong bite. Its teeth are those of a fish eater. It had relatively large eyes that were close to one another. The large eyes indicate that it hunted in the dark, murky, carboniferous swamps. They suggest either a nocturnal lifestyle or deep water hunting. These bizarre traits indicate that Crassigyrinus had lost the functionality of its limbs and consequently reverted to an aquatic lifestyle. They would have no use for land locomotion. They would have still functioned as rudders and may have been used for pushing through dense undergrowths of aquatic plants. It is possible that they may have also been used for mating, allowing a male to hold onto a female during the spawning process, similar to modern amphibians nowadays. Additionally, the pelvis didn't have a solid connection to the spine, as can be observed in terrestrial vertebrates. Its streamlined body shape suggests that it was a fast-moving predator. Analysis of the skull reveals a predatory lifestyle. The jaws feature two rows of teeth, along with two elongated fangs, perfect for biting into fish. The jaws could open relatively wide and seem to have had supporting muscle structure to inflict powerful bites, meaning that once Crassigyrinus was clamped on, there was no escape. Additionally, the snout of the skull had multiple ridges to it, suggesting reinforcement to cope with the stress of a high bite force. It's possible that Crassigyrinus needed these adaptations for coping with prey that were also rather powerful, suggesting predatory specialization. The tail isn't well known as specimens weren't preserved as well as the other parts. Given the size of the small limbs, it may have been large to compensate for them, and from what tail fragments that have been recovered, may have been flattened laterally. Such an adaptation would have allowed for stable locomotion in the water, as well as rapid bursts of speed. Multiple foramina on the humeral surfaces are very similar to those seen in Acanthostega, Ichthyostega, and lobe-finned fishes like Eustenopteron. Crassigyrinus means thick frog or thick tadpole. It was named by Watson in 1929. Species include the type, which is Crassigyrinus scoticus, or C. scoticus. It was a carnivore and may have favored the ambush predator approach instead of just cruising around looking for a snack like the modern-day freshwater pike. A pike has a very stunted tail as compared to other fish, yet it will often lurk amongst the reeds waiting for prey items to swim close enough to be within striking distance. Once close enough, it lines itself up and uses its short but powerful tail to produce a rapid burst of speed at its target. Its wide mouth, the mouth of a pike, filled with teeth, means that whatever is in front of it has little chance of getting away, possibly not unlike Crassigyrinus. It was relatively large, at 6 feet 6 inches or 2 meters in length. It has been found in Scotland, Europe, and possibly Greer, West Virginia, North America. It lived during the Bichon of the Early Carboniferous around 345 to 329 million years ago. Fossil representation includes several incomplete specimens and 3 skulls. And with that, thank you for watching this program episode of Prehistoric Beasts as a short fact-based episode. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.